Hello guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Joshua Matthew. If you are old here, thanks. If you are new here, kindly subscribe to my channel to get notified when I upload a new video. So let's get started. In this tutorial, I'm going to use 2000 pixels then to create my background, then and my resolution is 3000. I'm going to use a gradient fill in this tutorial. I'm going to copy my gradient color code which I already put in place. This one. And this, then increase the opacity to 100%, then I will have something like this. Now, okay. Also, I'm going to apply hue in this tutorial. This will be minus 22 and my lightness will be minus 55. Then it will be like this. Clip art to the color field, then close it. Then the next thing to do, I'm going to bring this background. Yeah, then I'm going to scale it out, then I'm going to leave it here, then I'll reduce my opacity to 59 like this, then I will apply a mask. I'll go to my brush to pick a brush so that I will remove the edge over there like this. It's okay. Then what I'm going to do next is to bring this background here. Then I'm going to scale it out, then position it like this. Then I'm going to my blending mode. I'm going to use saturation like this. So this is what I have. Okay. Then now I will bring the pastor, the anointing oil image. I'm going to put it, then bring it down here. Then I'm going to apply mask, then I'm going to remove those colored over there. Okay. I'm going to apply my blending mode like this. Then I will also bring my church logo to this place. I will select rectangle. Then this rectangle, I'm going to apply a color like this. I will apply the dark corner angle there. Now I will select the tool, then I centralize it, then increase my logo. Use your arrow key then to bring it down. Now I'm going to select my church name. I'm going to copy it. Then I'm using font Lato. Then paste. Ctrl V to paste. Then I'm going to apply Ctrl A to centralize it like this, then Ctrl D to deselect the line there. Then I'm going to select my logo on the rectangle there, then to move it so that there will be space between the church name and the logo. I'm going to apply a space between the two lines of the church name . 14 is okay. Left. Now I will reduce the size of this logo like this. Okay, now the next thing to do is to copy this one. I'll drag it down here, pick my test tool, then I'm going to highlight it, and I'm going to bring present. So the church present, paste, Ctrl V. Then I'm going to scale it out. Like this, it's okay. Ctrl A, then to centralize it. Ctrl B to remove the line. Now I will group my background and rename it. That is my background. Then what I'm going to do next, I'm going to copy this one, then where I'm going to put my special. Now I'm going to Ctrl J on this one, remove it up, then drag this one down and position it here, then highlight and paste it. Now I have something like this. I'm going to use fonts name Trajan Pro 3. That is the font I'm going to use. I will select the bold one. I'm going to use the bold. So this is what I'm going to use. I'm going to increase the size like this. Then I'm going to close the space a little bit. Okay, like this. Then this is the color I'm going to use. Gradient color. I will leave the code in the description. Now, what I'm going to do next is to apply a blending option. So, inner bevel, chisel hard. Then I'm going to use my depth as 115, like this. Then the size should be around 43. The softness 0. My contour, I'm going to use this one here. So then my highlight is going to be normal. My opacity is going to be 70. Then my shadow normal, then 100%. That is for my highlight, it's 100%. And my shadow is going to be 70%, like this. Then I'll come to my inner glow, normal, and I will increase the opacity small. That is 63. Then the size of this one, 7, is okay. Then this one is okay. Then I'm going to satin like this, and I'm going to apply. A yellow color, that is orange color. I think orange color will be better. Then okay. Then I'm going to use normal here so that the color will pop out. And I'm going to increase the opacity to 100. Then my distance 74 and size 18. Now the shadow. The shadow is going to be normal. Then the opacity 66. Then the distance. Distance should be 7. Then the spread should be 21, and the size, should be 23. Okay, That is all. Okay. Now, what I will do again is to duplicate this one, Ctrl J. Then I'll bring this one down like this. Then my test tool, then highlight it. I'm going to copy anointing, then Ctrl V. Now I'm going to reduce the size. Let me zoom it out so that you guys can see it well. Then I'm going to copy this one again, Ctrl J. I'm going to move it down. Then highlight it. Then I'm going to copy service. Then I'll paste it. Then you have something like this. I will drag it here. Make sure they are aligned. Here come. So now you have something like this. Then the next thing to do, I'm going to select my date and time. So dates, then the font I'm going to use is Lato, then heavy, and I'm going to paste it Sunday. Sunday 10th. Then I will Ctrl J to copy this one, then drag it down. Then I'm going to type 10 here. Then I will drag this one like this. Then I will also copy this one, then drag it down like this. Then highlight it and I will type 2021. Then I drag it out. Sorry. Drag it out. It's okay. Now I'm going to bring a rectangle to put a separation here. I'm going to use a yellow color like this. Then I will copy this 2020, Ctrl J. Then I will drag it here. Then my test tool, click and highlight. Now put 9 a.m. like this. Then I will drag it so that it will be bigger like this. Now I'm going to bring time and date into the Photoshop. and reduce the size. Now I'm going to rasterize this one, that is the calendar. I'm going to rasterize it, go to my magic tool, then I'm going to select this one, the white color. I'm going to select this white color, then I delete, then Ctrl D. Then also the inner white here, I'm going to delete them. I'm going to delete this one like this, Ctrl D. Then the next thing to do is to select this black here. Then I'm going to apply white color over there. Then I'm going to select my paint pocket tool. Then you can see here is white. Then I'm going to apply white here like this. So Ctrl D to remove the line. Then now I'm going to drag it. Now that I've decreased it like this, position it, then okay. Then the other one again is this. Now we drag it down. I'm going to drag it down. So now that I've decreased it, I'm going to position it at the back here. But before then, I'm going to my image adjustment, then hue, then and take it to 100% white. Then it's going to be white. Now what I will do here now, because I want to position this one at the back here, so now what I'm going to do is to highlight all this one from Sunday here, then and group it. Now that I group it, then I will now move it. I'll move it. Then okay. We'll bring this one here like this. Now that I bring this one to that position, I will scale it, decrease it a little bit, then okay. Now I'm going again, then yes, so that it will be in line with this. So I got something like this. So the next thing I'm going to do now is to decrease it like this, then move it up like this. Okay, then select the service. I'm going to group this one. Then let me test. That is my logo. What I will do next is to bring a brush that I'm going to use in the background here. Okay, good. Now I'm going to here to my brush, I'm going to select a color like this. Color like this, then I'm coming here, then I'm going to drop it here, then I have something like this. Now I'm going to duplicate this one, Ctrl G. So the one at the top, I'm going to change the color then to white. Then I'll select my pocket tool, then to apply white color. Then I'm going to use my arrow key and to reduce it like this. Then now I will bring my image. To the top like this. Then my text. This. My time and date. My time and date. I will move it up. And scale it out like this. Now I'm going to bring the location. The location, copy it, then select my text tool, then I'm paste. Now I'm going to change the color . Now I'm going to displace to reduce the space like this. Then I'm going to select 12 there. The color, make it dark a bit. Something like this. Now I will bring this location logo here and drag it down. I position it here. Now I have something like this. Then I will go back again to my rectangle and draw a rectangle like this. Then I'll also select this color. Like this. I will copy this one, Ctrl J. Now I'm going to drag it up. Bring it here. Then change the color to white. And highlight it. I'm going to type. Pastor. Pastor Timothy Johnson. Now, I'm going to centralize the name. Then reduce it to 10. Reduce the space to 11. Okay. Now, bring it down by using your arrow key. Now I'm going to fade the rectangle a bit so that it will not that be too dark. Okay. Now this is how the design was made. So the last thing is to go to is to group this and name it Pastor. This is location. Brush. Now I'm going to the last final thing to do. I'm going to camera roll. Wow. Then I got this.